Okay, we're back on the Sports Max Zone now, and plans to upgrade the Cassata Gardens horse racing track in Antigua and Barbuda remain at the forefront of efforts to revitalize the sport in that eastern Caribbean island. That's the word from the president of the Antigua Turf Club, Neil Cochran. Development plans at the facility have been retarded by numerous issues, and apart from the acquisition of a harrow, equipment used to loosen the soil on the track, and the purchase of several feet of rails, nothing has been done to improve up to this point the facility. The setback to the development plans also had an impact on the timeline for elections for posts on the Turf Club executive. Joining us now to talk about this, president of the Antigua Turf Club, Neil Cochran. Neil, welcome to the Sports Max Zone for about the third or fourth time. Great to have you on the show.
It's been a while. Yeah, thanks for having me.
Yes, in the past you've been here talking about Caribbean Football Union issues as well, when you were a part of that body. I see you're getting a lot of media time in Antigua and Barbuda over this horse racing issue. Can I ask first about the elections and the Turf Club executive? How soon will those elections be held, and what are your hopes of retaining your position?
The timeline has not really been set for elections. Of course, we would have been hampered by the COVID, and so it's been well over a year since we've passed the due date for election. What we've been really focusing on is trying to raise the necessary funds for the upgrades to the facility. But now that we're becoming, getting back to some degree of normalcy on island, we will now begin to focus and put some attention to the elections. But our focus really has been on generating and trying to get the amount of revenue needed for the upgrade.
Yeah. Neil Cochran, in a nutshell, can you just explain to us why there hasn't been any racing at Cassata Gardens in Antigua and Barbuda since since June 2019? We're pretty much 2 years on.
Well, we would have had our scheduled race would have been then August, coming out of the Triple Crown series. We would have had to race in August, our carnival race meet. That was postponed. When we looked at the historical information, there were lots of big events that were taking place on that day. And we would have seen significant losses over that particular period. So we had some issues with scheduling then. Thereafter, it just went into weather, the cycle just continued to the end of that year, and then we ended up in COVID. And so, you know, that is just the reality that we face. And so, we still have not been given the green light to race. I can tell you that we have had, you know, our horses continue to exercise. And on the I can say, ever so often, you know, we have what you call some match races just to keep them going, to keep them fit. We have landed a container of rails, brand new rails. We have landed a new, what we call a track conditioner, which is the hardware that is used to keep the track surface going. We've been able to secure the services of an engineer, a racetrack engineer from California, who is redesigning the racing surface as well as the shape of the track, because it is not the international standard at the moment. So that has been done as well. And so our focus now is to look forward, not to look back at what has happened or has transpired. We don't control nature, but we certainly now are getting closer and closer to reopening. And we hope, even if the upgrades have not started, if we do get permission, we may have a final race on the existing facility before we get into, you know, breaking down and reshaping and relaying of the surface.
I know that a lot of Caribbean jockeys, and maybe less so trainers, have left the region to seek employment elsewhere. There are, you know, scores and scores of Caribbean riders at the moment in Canada, for instance. Kwame Joseph, one of your leading riders, has been in Canada for a while. How much has the staff of horse racing in Antigua and Barbuda been hamstrung by all of this?
They've been significantly hamstrung. You know, it's very difficult to maintain horses and not being able to really and truly enjoy them racing. and it's a costly venture. So it has been significant for me, and his dad and his team, they actually are still up in Canada. For me, I think he's now more exercising than anything else, because his weight and maintaining that weight has been a challenge for him. But his dad has been doing very well as a trainer, as his own barn now, and a winning trainer in Canada. I forgot the name of the track that he's at right now. But the first track that they got, for instance, also closed down. So, you know, racing globally has been trending, I think, pretty negatively in terms of a lot of the tracks closing down and a lot of issues with horses, their health, and stuff like that. So, you know, in Antigua, we are not as privileged in terms of the funding for horse racing, whereas the backbone in Barbados may be the lottery. In Jamaica, you have the end of that, and also significant help from governments and so on. You know, we get concessions, but at the end of the day, the facility and everything that's there, it's all as a result of the efforts of the turf club. And when you have a small population of maybe 100,000 persons or so, and every sport going to them, it's not easy. And so we understand the battles that we're faced with. And as, you know, president, I'm satisfied with what, you know, we've accomplished. But we also realize that a lot more can be done. So, you know, we are really making the effort to raise the funds. And we did make some inroads there. And that's why the things that I've told you, we've managed to purchase and so on, that's on the ground. And just to move sand from Antigua to, from Barbados to Antigua to go on the surface, cost us another $15,000 US.
Yeah.
And, you know, so it's tough.
Neil, we are out of time, but I have to squeeze this one in. And I'm happy that you're talking development, not looking back. The question, though, with the investment that you are seeking to attract for a facility that you've gone to court for, Justice Astafan sided with you, of course, in the dispute over the ownership of Cassada Gardens, with the investment that you're looking to bring in, is that facility and where it's located, is that the future, medium and long term, for horse racing in Antigua and Barbuda, or does the future of racing lie elsewhere in terms of a location for the track facility?
The future could lie elsewhere, but as it stands right now, we have to work with what we have. There's no other lands that have been made available to us. We have had several discussions. And we're not looking to make much more than a boutique racetrack. We want it to be maintained as a very intimate setting. Lands are there, and he understands where we're come from with that. But for us, we're very passionate about the races. We're passionate about how close the people get to the excitement. So we want to have a boutique racetrack, no more than 6 furlongs, which has a grandstand that facilitates 1,000 persons with the amenities. And we want to have about 200 stalls. The most important thing for us is to ensure that our racing stock also is refreshed.
Yeah.
Because that is one of our challenges.
Yeah. Hear you on that, Neil. Thank you very much for your time. All the best.
No problem. Thank you, guys. And it's good being here.
Good. Neil Cochran. He is the president of the Antigua the Turf Club there. The fact is, the track is, as it stands, 5.5 furlongs, 40 feet across. It's small, but he says the intention is not to make it like Jamaica, which is one of the largest in the hemisphere. Yeah. It's to make it boutique, small, fit for purpose, and that's what they're investing in. We wish them all the best.
Yeah.